Women are strong enough, we don't need any special treatment.
I don't want the entire world to know that I have periods. It's my personal thing.
We spent the last 100 years saying that we are equal, that our biology does not make us any different at the workplace. And suddenly we say that our bodies are such that we need extra time off.
It's just going to invite a lot of comment on something that's actually very private to an individual.
For you to expect a woman to come in while she's in pain and to expect her to work at 100%, that doesn't make sense. And the only reason why you haven't really noticed is because women don't talk about it. You know, most women, or me back in the days, I wouldn't tell you that I had my period and I wasn't 100%. But I promise you, I wasn't working as well as I was working when I didn't have my period.
Stop making people who bleed feel guilty for a bodily function they didn't choose, for pain they didn't choose.
And why should we continue to face that pain and continue this culture of and tradition of enduring toxic pain when it's not good for us? I have intense period pains and it stopped me from doing like a lot of different things.
I have suffered extreme dysmenorrhea since I got my periods at the age of 30.
When I'm on my period, I'm in pain, I'm in my bed, I'm crying my eyes out, I'm taking, you know, I take 4 pills every like 4 hours. Some women vomit and yet you're still expected to work. It's not women, it's the work environment that needs to change.
Let's look at it from an employer's point of view. Let's say you are an employer and you are given 2 resources of different genders. And you're told they're equally qualified, they're equally competent, but one will take 10 days more off in a year than the other. Who would you hire?
I started off having periods for 12 days. So do I expect to take off for 8 days? I mean, I would get it, but what happens to my career?
If you're going to have large number of women working in the company, how are you going to plan a project if each of it is going to be decided by the monthly cycles of each woman? I mean, it's really not practical.
You're basically saying that if you don't sort this out, if you don't deal with it, if you aren't, showing up in whatever condition your bodies are, then you'll be discriminated against.
When you have someone who is disabled at work, right, that person can do the same work that somebody else can do, right? But you are going to make a few changes around the working environment because you're bringing in the concept of equity. Probably when maternity leave was first included, it was a big deal. It doesn't make women any less efficient. A lot of companies have that.
If you're a company that's going to discriminate against a person for bleeding, then I don't think that's a very good place to work. I think that's a very toxic atmosphere.
I understand the sheer pain of periods. I think all of us do. But I think that the real world does not look at these issues. I don't think that a business world or a corporate world looks at these issues. It should, but right now it doesn't.
It's not that they're against it, it's that they are worried. And again, it's because they are gaslighted by a society that was built by men for men. That's what it is.